morning.
Fried or scrambled?
Is this guilt?
It's breakfast.
No, I'm not sure I could eat her.
Oh, come on, Carl. I don't want to hurt you, you know.
Don't want to marry me either.
It was just a bit sudden, that's all. Our heads are still all over the place. The pub's not sorted. I feel all over the place.
Well, that's when you need something nailed down, anchoring you.
Yes, I know, but...
But? I hate but.
But can't we just take it one day, one egg on toast at a time, please? It's about all I can cope with right now.
Mum? Mm-hmm. See me gimlet?
You what, Luke?
Me gimlet. You make holes with it and stuff.
No. Hey, this is the house of good moves. Don't spoil it on Paul's first day back.
Yeah, I know, it's just more shelling out, though, innit, eh?
Is the giblet short?
Ow, can you operate?
Yeah, well, you can lose hours on a job without the right equipment. You should know that. Your job's equipment.
So when did you last have it?
Flaming Rovers.
Wooden or metal?
Eh?
Well, would it survive in a fire?
Well, I wouldn't ask them lot, even if it could. Wouldn't give Carla satisfaction.
Do you want me to ask?
Forget about it. It's just somehow she's took off me.
Oh, look, I'll buy another one. Top of my shopping list. One giblet.
Gimlet.
Jace, can I have a word?
Sorry, pal, I can't. I'm late.
Catch him later.
What about?
Fancy a bacon sandwich?
No, I fancy you more. Come on, let's go back to bed.
You wouldn't have even thought about it if Gary and Izzy hadn't found out about their baby.
Look, come on. It'd be nice to know if it's a he or a she. You know, we could pick a name, get pots of paint, or his slash her slash their.
Oh, ain't twins.
You better show me that scan photo.
Oh, can't we just wait till it's born?
You see, there you go, it. I mean, if we knew it was a he or a she, we wouldn't have to talk like it's a pet lizard, like a pack of frozen peas.
David should have a say in all this as well, you know.
Here, here.
Having said that, it might be nice to wait. More fun.
Yeah, well, you like surprises, I don't.
Right, grindstone. Can I pay you, please, Ray?
Hope you upset me.
You're champing at the bit, are you?
Well,
man's got to earn a crust, love.
I would have thought you'd be smacking Rob over the head with it by now.
Ah, quite like having a minion at my beck and call.
Uh-huh, so it was a good idea by Carla Connor Enterprises, was it?
We've had to put the hot drinks up 10p. I'm sorry, 1st of May, new prices.
Oh, do stop apologising, Roy. It is a barely discernible rise on a preposterously low cost.
Yes, yeah, I'm sorry. If £3.80 then, please, Peter.
Seen somewhere nice? You okay?
I thought you'd be out ogling workmen.
New earrings?
Oh, that used to freak me out when you were a kid. Your ability to spot the difference. Didn't you win something in Bunty once?
Earmuffs.
Yeah, it's like you had a superpower.
They're gorgeous. Where'd you get them from?
Town.
What were you doing in town?
Buying earrings.
You went all the way into town to buy earrings?
What's wrong with that?
Nout. Why are you looking so shifty then?
I'm not.
They look expensive.
Expensive? No. Well, I'm not cheap. Well, they had such a good display, I couldn't resist nipping in. All them sparkly earrings and necklaces and rings.
So you wander all the way into town for no reason, then you happen to pass the jewellers you can't resist. And why are you all dressed up?
I'm not. What is this, the Weatherfield Inquisition? Is that tea long brewed in that pot?
This is Carl, isn't it? You met up with him, didn't you?
Carl? I thought he'd gone for his checkup.
You've been helping him choose me a ring, haven't you?
Do you think he might propose?
He can't fool me, Mum. Did he not tell you he's already asked me?
Oh!
I said no.
Oh.
It's too fast.
Too fast? You've got cobwebs on your crow's feet, love.
Did he ask you to soften me up, then?
Next time he proposes, snap his hand off.
Oh, thanks for listening.
Well, life's too short. And there's no loneliness like loneliness that could be avoided. You want to snap up the sparkle in life before it's too late.
Oh, don't put pressure on me, Mum. I'm not ready, and that's that.
No earmuffs for getting this right. Spot the difference. One tired old tea bag clinging on to its last flavours in life.
Takes one to know one.
Yes.
Oh, they're off.
Is the coffee in or out? It's 10p more either way, I'm afraid. Sorry. Right. Not sorry.
Outer.
I'm going to get Brian to cook on Friday and get Rover.
Oh, if I don't get to bed soon, I'm going to have to eat the staff.
I would prefer to avoid that if possible.
All day breakfast, please.
Comfort eating.
Paul? Yeah, Royston.
Yes, sir.
I'm normally a single back kind of guy, but two bacon balms today, please, mate.
So. Yeah, looks like I'm stuck with him.
And me with her. We should think of it as community service.
Well, I wish you told me. We've been drawing up a rota here.
Get me. Mates, man, fry up. You know, if I were to die right now.
I'd kill you.
Is it? Jace.
I want all the gory details. I'll be round.
Me too.
How'd you get on without your gimlet?
Yeah, manage. Not ideal. Be my best tools for the job. You know, you get attached to them, don't you?
Yeah. Listen, I've got a job I reckon you're the best tool for.
Hey?
I'll rephrase that. Will you be my best man when I marry your mother?
Of course. Cheers, mate. Hey, I'm well happy for you both. And I know I've not seemed it. Just I've had a lot in my head, that's all. All right. Hey, mum. Best man.
Oh.
Yes.
Fancy cake.
And a coffee?
No, I've still got this, thanks.
Which was not purchased on the premises. You see, it's a slippery slope. Before we know where we are, we'll have people bringing in flasks from home.
Oh, I'm stopping away from home.
Why?
So I don't slap Stella's legs for being a brainless bimbo.
What's she done?
Carl proposed. What did she do? Turns him down flat.
Well, isn't entering a burning building and saving your life enough for women nowadays? I married Roy's father because he held a door open for me in Woolworths. Shall I dispose of that?
Oh, yeah, chuck it away. It was free anyway.
Free? From where?
So, how did you do nudging the insurance?
They're on it.
Good. Only average limit on tick and the boys will want paying on Friday.
Yeah, of course.
Why don't I have a chat with them, the insurance, explain what's happening?
Well, they said in a day.
Yeah, but I'm sure they can cough up an interim payment, if I'll lean on them a bit.
Why don't I write you a cheque, eh? See you through.
Well, if you can stretch to it, great. Make sure there are enough north the right side of the decimal point. New cheque-book.
New cheque-book, new purse, new bag, new shoes, new clothes. I lost everything in this place.
Except your life, eh? It can only get better from now on, love.
3, 4, 5, 6. You're out of fingers, mate. Let me know.
Oh, I'm just counting the number of bets that we've had this morning. Wednesday morning. Quite a shift.
Pre-mate?
50p each way on taking the rise, and I'll help myself to another coffee tower.
See, it's quality, mate. It's not quantity. I could run this place single-handed.
Excuse me. Excuse me, how would you like it if we were offering odds on how many pork sausages we could shift in a week?
Look, Sylvia, I've got to nip out, but you can speak to Robert, our development consultant. He could run this place single-handedly.
You are stealing our trade. And I'm very disappointed in you, Mr. MacDonald.
I was... Oh, come on, Sylvia. We're all business people here. Let's talk this through. Coffee?
Just the man. Fit and report for work, sir.
Well, the doc's giving you the all clear.
Yeah, good to go, name the day.
Listen, you couldn't hold on to the insurance and start paying out, will you? I can only just scrape this week's wages.
Mate, pay me whenever. In fact, I work for now. I want to see this place brand new, so whatever speeds that up.
Well, I'll have that in writing. You couldn't stick around for 5 minutes, could you? Save me locking up. I'm only going to grab a butty.
Yeah, crack on, mate, yeah.
Cheers.
Don't you smokers get bored standing outside buildings on your own day in and day out?
I'm not smoking. I'm drinking coffee.
No.
A man is entitled to stand in a public place, breathing free air and drinking free coffee.
Free coffee? Mm-hmm. What, from in there? Do you know, Roy Cropper's just put his prices up. That's bad timing, isn't it? I wonder if he's aware.
Tell him, Norris. Mind you, I'm sure he'd be more bothered if you had a free coffee in
here. What are you saying? Are you suggesting I'm being vindictive?
No.
Good. Still, I suppose one has the right to partake of what's being offered.
You need not to.
Yeah.
Oh,
Thinking of taking a gamble, Norris?
No, not gamble. No, it was just change. We need more change.
Well, we have some in the cafe. You can come and purchase a coffee and I'll count some out for you.
Yes, well, I think I'll try the bistro.
Don't think it's worth it.
You what?
Everything you've done. Still think it's worth it.
You're obsessed.
I know you know.
Know what? Is this about your van again?
No. Stella, she turned you down flat. She doesn't want you, mate. Do you still think it's worth walking to a fire for her?
Me and Stella are solid.
I bet if I carried Angelina Jolie out of a fire, I could get a few dates.
So you wouldn't have the guts to rescue in the first place. You'd leave it to the men.
It'll wear off. Stella knows it. That's why she won't marry you. It's just a matter of time, isn't it? Eh? Before she moves on. Why stay with a loser?
She didn't. She dumped you.
Tick. Tick. Tick.
Started it. Only brought it as a joke for your mother.
No, but it drives me mad. There's always one you can't get.
Oh, that's Stella.
That bloke's got a ring on his finger. Oh.
The irony.
Mum, irony, what?
Large white wine, was it?
Oh, certainly was. You can manage a large one, can't you?
I'll get these.
I said I'd get them.
Is there a pensioner's discount or something?
No, Norris.
Extortion at this place. When are you going to break his monopoly?
Listen, Norris, nobody wants the pub reopened more than I do. Thanks.
Carl's proposed.
Oh, you're joking. She's not going to marry him.
Well, she's turned him down for now.
Yeah, forever if I have my way. Oh, hello, speak of the devil.
I need to ask you something.
I know what you're going to say. My mum is a terrible liar.
Eh?
You bought me a ring?
No.
Is it true? About him proposing. Oh, soul of discretion, my mother. Oh, getting in there before she can think straight. Actually, I can make my own decisions, you know. Yeah, well, it's not a good time to be making decisions. Remember that after what you've been through.
Maybe the best time. Life's too short and all that.
Too short to make big mistakes. Have you finished interfering?
She wants to mind her own business.
Yeah, she gets it from her gran. What did you want to talk to me about that was so urgent?
If you love me.
Can't.
Do you?
Yes.
I want you to be happy. That's all that matters to me. You get that, don't you? And everything I do is only for that. Sorry, I'll stop. I'm trying to stop her. I need to know you know.
I know. Okay? But just do me a favour. Chill out for a bit, will you? See you later.
Do you know what? I think I'm going to have to get the punters to start putting their coffees down every time a race gets exciting. This is the third spill.
Well, how come you're Mrs. Mopp? What is Peter doing?
Just watching him on CCTV. Oh, by the way, Rob, you missed a bit.
You must be exhausted, babe. Listen, I suggest a bath and an early night. Both with me.
Oh, no. I'm sorry, I should have said. You're working, mate. There's a meeting at Cheltenham tonight.
Why can't you cover it?
Well, I can't. There's a rota here, and that's your copy.
Don't worry, Rob. Just knock on number one when you're finished. I'll be waiting.
He'd think he'd text you, yes or no.
Put you out your misery.
He'll want to tell me face to face, see how I react.
And how are you going to react if he gets his job back?
How's this? Oh. All right.
So, when's he due home?
Well, he's been press-ganged into a couple of drinks with the lads. Oh, and we won't be going on that holiday if he gets this job, because he'll be working.
I'm really happy for you, Eileen.
Keep hold of him this time.
Hello. We're just off.
See you later.
Right. See you later. See, you got him before me.
Oh, they brought it. They're pleased for us. Oh, does this mean what I think it means?
My boss was off ill.
Yeah?
Yeah. And my letter of resignation was still in his entry. Depp said they would love to have me back.
Well, that's great. I'll, get your glass.
Look, Eileen, I know part of you must have hoped they'd replace me.
No, 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 this is... It's really great, yeah. So, when do you start?
Friday.
Friday?
Yeah. I was like the prodigal fireman. The lads almost carried me shoulder high into the pub.
Well, I best get A&E on the speed dial.
Eileen,
no,
please.
No, no, no. I meant, you know, if you're going to be carried into the pub by a bunch of giddy gippers.
Sorry, I thought you...
Let's just get this bottle open and drink to you doing what you love. OK?
Thank you.
Hmm. Not your phone, is it?
No.
It's under here if anyone asks.
You weren't gonna bother.
Meet your future grandchild.
Oh, oh, that's lovely. And what did you decide about finding out whether it was a boy or a girl?
We decided against telling you.
Why?
Well, you said you like surprises.
So you know.
Yeah? It's
I'm gonna have to kill him. But everything's all right. I mean, you're all right.
Yeah, they were a little bit worried about your blood pressure, though.
Only to keep an eye on.
Yeah, well, all the same, I think it's wise if we start looking for maternity cover ASAP.
Whatever Kylie wants, we'll manage.
No, I don't want.
All right, well, we'll vote then. All those in favour of you working and against. All right, you see that? She raised an hand.
Ah!
Oh, yes! Sorry.
Sorry. Beautiful little girl. Perfect. Is he okay?
Yeah, he's fine. Said he had a dream. Something about a jellyfish attacking him.
Mm, bet it was that egg I made him. Didn't look done enough.
Oh, I don't know. He's not squeamish. He's grown up on Deirdre's cooking, remember? Anyway, look, he's gone back to sleep, so I thought we could have an early night.
You tired, love?
No.
Bye-bye, Sudoku.
Look, you go through, love. I've just got to check on Rob.
Why, is he still working?
Yeah, I'll be through in a sec.
Okay, good night.
Seriously? One kidney?
I like to be different.
Which one?
You see, that's what I like about you. You are so random. Of all questions to ask, which one?
What do people normally ask?
Why? When? Whose?
Oh, I'll swing for Peter. If you need me, it'll have to wait till the morning, because me and Carla are having an early night. You know what that's about, don't you?
Yeah, he reckons he's having all the fun.
It's so petty.
Which kidney? Well, if you want to see the little scar, I'm going to have to take my top off.
No, Mum, I've not seen it. Where did you last have it? Right, well, listen, nobody's handed it in, but I'll have a look. All right, yep. Bye.
Stella?
Yeah, she's lost her phone. I bet Carl's lifted it, flogged it and put the old lot on her nose.
Sorry to disappoint you.
Why is he rushing her into marrying him?
Because he loves her.
Well, don't take his side.
I'm not. She's a grown woman. She knows what she's doing. She said no, isn't she?
Yeah, for now. But he won't let it go, will he? Not till he's got his feet under the table. And then he'll let her down. He will, because he's a lowlife. Right, I'll let her know it's here. Hiya. Oh, right, that's great. Yeah, if it's not too much trouble. See you then, bye. Leanne's got me phone.
Shall I nip over?
No, she said she'll drop it over.
Give her a chance to start with her poison again.
Oh, what poison?
About us.
Oh, look, don't let it get to you. I don't. She's just a worrier, that's all. It's sweet. And it shows we're right, not rushing into things if other people seem to think that we are and all.
Oh, so you are letting her get to you?
Oh, Carl, I do love you, but you're doing me head in today. If you want to go and get the phone, go and get the phone. Oh, I'm just on my way to yours now.
Stella's phone. I'll take that.
No, you're all right. I need to have a chat with her anyway.
Yeah, I bet you do.
Meaning?
Wading in there, trying to put her off me.
I'm entitled to my opinion.
And I'm entitled to tell you to keep your opinions to yourself.
Well, the day I start listening to what you tell me to do.
You've got a right gob on you, haven't you?
You don't deserve her. Well, you might be the hero of the hour right now. But I know what you're capable of, and I'm going to be over her shoulder making sure she doesn't forget that for a single second.
Keep your spiteful tongue in your bitter, nasty little head. Because if you keep this up, I promise you, you will regret it. You got that?
You don't scare me.
Well, Weatherfield and Walford go to war this week on Celebrity Juice. May the best team win. Corrie, of course. Tomorrow at 10 on ITV2. Next, it's always a bit embarrassing when you don't know the other half quite as well as you thought. A hairy biker and a star of Corrie do battle in an all-star Mr. and Mrs.